Please turn off all cell phones. Rishos Rosh Yeshiva, Ranan Rabbeisai, on behalf of Talmidei Yeshivas Mir here in Chicago, I'd like to be makatov to Baal Sanya, Skokie Yeshiva, Rabbi Freeman, Rabbi Eisenberg, for being Masander, Shloshim, the Hespedim, covered a Nifter, for the covered a Tibur, for covered a Taira. There's no secret that Marina Rosh Yeshiva, Nosson Tzvi Finkel, Zechatzadik of Racha, felt the closest affinity to Chicago. Well, every time I would see him in Eretz Yisrael, he would say, "Welcome home." But he certainly felt home here in Chicago, and specifically here in the Skokie Yeshiva. He was a graduate of the academy, but in his senior year, he spent time learning with individual rabbeim and Herzl Kaplan, who actually encouraged him to go to Eretz Yisrael at the time, very rare in the 1960s. He told his parents that when people excel and people have a desire to grow in various subjects, that's where they should be directed. Your son of Nosson Tzvi has a cheshik and a tremendous avos haTorah. He'll be matziach and he'll be a gadol b'Torah. He then went to Rabbi Yehoshua Levinson, Rabbi Levinson's Levi in Eretz Yisrael. Rabbi Nosson Tzvi ran to his kever, to the Aron, and cried, "Rebbe, Rebbe." Again, a sign of his affection is a Karas HaTayef, the Rebbeim he had here in Chicago. We say three times a day in Shemoneh Esrei, we daven for many things in Shemoneh Esrei. The one thing that causes us yogan v'anacha is Hashir Shoftein et Varishona. We ask for refu, we ask for parnasa, but we don't say v'nas yogan v'anacha. Only Hashir Shoftein et Varishona, the Yosin et Matachila. We lost the tremendous Eitzah, the tremendous initiatives, the vision, the global vision, the vision for each Talmud. The Marina Rosh Yeshiva had for us and gave us, gave to all of Klal Yisrael. The Chicago Jewish community is fortunate to have with us a member of the Moetzes Gedolei HaTaira, a Rav Chaim Levin, Rosh Yeshiva, Yeshiva itself, Chicago, who is a source of Eitzah and of guidance for every aspect of Yiddishkeit throughout the community. It's a kavod gadol to hear the Hesped from Rosh Yeshiva Rav Chaim Levin Shlita.
Spoke for a few minutes at the first Hesped that we had in the city. So at that time I mentioned the Mishnah in the beginning of the sixth parak in Avos, there were a mayor Omer called Isaac Tarly Shema Zechli Dvorim Harbe. And he gives a whole list of great things that a person could be zeicha learning Torah Lishma. So when the Chazai Nish, Zichayin HaBracha, passed away, so our Rebbe, Rav Elimer Bloch, said a hesped, and I was there at the hesped, and later it was printed, but he went through this whole Mishnah, and he said that every single word of the Mishnah was fulfilled in the Chazon Ish. And it's astounding that a person in that generation was able to obtain everything that it said in the Mishnah. He said it's only because he learned to early Shema. I'm not my Rebbe Reimer Bloch, and I can't say about the grace of Nifter that every single thing in the Mishnah was Mekuyim on him. But so many things were, that it says in the Mishnah were Mekuyim on the grace of Nifter. So many things that were Mekuyim on him. Oyeves Abrius, Mesameach Es Amokim, Mesameach Es Abrius. Nenin imenu eitzel sashiva binu gvura noisenas loy malchus memshole was echet to become the Rosh Yeshiva of the largest yeshiva in the world. And such a tamach chocham naitz gemayna misgaber, it could only be because he learned early Shema. No question that he learned early Shema. When we came into the city 1960, he had just left, or he was leaving. Go to Eretz Yisrael. There's no question that he learned 30 years, he learned Torah Lishma. To reach a Chicago boy, an American boy, no different than all the other young men in Chicago. And he reached such a high madrega, such a level in Torah and Avoda, in Afotzas Torah. It's only because he spent 30 years learning Torah Lishma, no question about it. Otherwise, it would have been impossible. And after 30 years learning Torah Lishma, then he was called upon min haShemayim to assume the position of Rosh Yeshiva of Mir for 21 years. He developed and built the yeshiva until it became the greatest yeshiva, the biggest yeshiva in the world. But he prepared himself. He prepared himself as learned Torah Lishma. We have to know what Torah Lishma means, but Nefesh HaChaim says Torah Lishma means very simple. I'm learning Torah because this is the word of Hashem Yisborach. This is the word of God, and I have to understand the Torah. And someone that learns Torah Lishma can be zeichet to tremendous milas. We say, Maisa Yishu Pkudosoi. Our Rosh Yeshiva Chaim Rav is to say that every person has a certain Pkuda. Every certain person has a mission in life. And he's judged. Maisa Yishu Pkudosoi. Did he fulfill his mission? Did he reach his Pkuda? Did he reach the position that he was supposed to reach? And every person has to prepare himself. Every person in his life has to prepare himself for certain moments that he could possibly be called on, moments of godless, moments of great potential. We always say over, Rashi brings down the Medrash Rabbah by Pinchas, and by the Maisa, Heima Boichem, Moshe Rabbeinu was crying, Heima Boichem, Vayar Pinchas, and Pinchas stood up. So Rashi brings down the Chazal, Be'egel Omad Moshe Keneged Shishim Ribui. By the Egel, Moshe Rabbeinu had the power to stand up against 600,000 Jews. V'kan Rofu Yodov. And over here, his hands were weakened. What happened over here? The grace of Gibor, Moshe Rabbeinu, why were the hands weakened? Ela Kedei Shiyove Pinchas Shiyitol Mashe Hoyoloi. In order that Pinchas should come and attain what's due to him. This was not the moment of Moshe Rabbeinu's godless. Moshe Rabbeinu had plenty of moments in his life plenty of moments of potential greatness, and he utilized those moments of potential greatness. This was not his moment. This was Pinchas' moment. It was the moment for Pinchas to step up and use his potential and develop his potential and save Klal Yisrael. Altiv was the Chaladim Chazal say Novus. Every single person has certain times in his life, moments in his life of potential greatness. He has to prepare, every person has to prepare himself and then utilize those moments in life of potential greatness. He has to utilize those moments. Pinchas utilized that was his moment of potential greatness, and he utilized those moments. And every person in his life has to prepare himself, because sometime in his lifetime, the Rebbein Shalom will give him English Shor, there'll be certain hours that he can utilize his potential to the greatest extent for the benefit of Klal Yisrael, for the benefit of Kiddush Shem Shamayim. We always say over on Rabbi Akiva, Rabbi Akiva in his lifetime had three moments in his lifetime that he utilized those moments to achieve the greatness of becoming this great Tana. He had three moments. He had one moment when he was still in Amoritz, and then he was in Amoritz and didn't learn Torah. He thought he could never learn Torah.